Well, I met JoAnna because of porn, because we both had a mutual friend and she was getting married. So Joe came to the wedding. I was at the wedding, and that's when I first met Joe.
It's funny because I met Joe out of this. I met Leah first, and then I met JoAnna later. But I always thought that she was kind of quiet. I would have never thought those two get. They got those two got together on my wedding day. So, and I found out after the fact. I was like, "What? Corn better treat her right because she's really sweet, and I don't want him, you know, messing up."
Well, JoAnna is 9 years older than me, but she was always happy, you know, took me under her wing as her little sister. I always remember her singing. She shared a room with Leah. So I wasn't always able to be a part of their mix, you know, with her being older. But always very caring. I can't think of anything negative about JoAnna growing up.
If I could say anything, she was a great example of what a big sister should be. She encompasses all of the ingredients and the quality of what an older sibling should be. And I loved that she was my sister and she was my best friend.
She's still crazy when she want to be. You know what I mean? She's outgoing.
Yes. She's not an introvert. She loves to laugh. Of course, our whole family loves to laugh. You see that,
we
right?
We like to have fun.
And we like to have fun. And I think your mom is just like that. Yeah. And, you know, your grandmother was like that.
Yeah.
Sure, I like to have fun, too. Sure, I love to laugh.
Yeah.
Corn and I are, you know, several years apart in age. So when I met him, I had just become a youth leader. So we both went to the same camp, and he was one of the youth there. He was the jokester, okay? Always, you know, funny, being funny and stuff like that. But when it came to God, he did get serious.
He was cool. He thought he was real cool, and he was a knucklehead. Corn rode. He had a car. Forgot the name, the make of the car, but he called it the Scully Low. He was the homeboy. He had his cool jam tapes, and he liked to play his music loud. He was a basketball player. He was young, handsome guy. You know, the girls liked him and stuff. So he got a lot of attention. Thank God Joe came into the scene and changed his whole life. So before Joe, it was hilarious, but it was all preparation for getting together with her, I think.
You guys met him before I did. I think I met him when they actually got married.
Well, I was grilling everybody. I will give you the eyeball and give you the what for.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, I was pretty hard on him a little bit, but he's always had a good sense of humor, and he treated her nice.
Yeah.
And I think that's the biggest thing. And he loved the Lord.
Yeah.
That was number one. He loved the Lord, and he treated her nice.
Treated her well. Yes.
And, you know, because if there was any things happening, I don't think I was too saved back then.
Well, we all were saved, but we just had to put it down and take care of business. And
that's what I'm talking
that's
about.
That's about how
pick
that
it back up.
Yeah.
You know.
I met your dad in the mall, and I knew he was a ball player because he's a year behind me. So our two schools were rival schools, and everybody was talking about, man, you got to see this brother, man. This brother from Tacoma, man, he's a baller. So I never got a chance to sing because I was on tour. It was my rookie year. So I came back and I was in the mall with some ball players, and this guy was walking down the mall with a high top fade, a red t-shirt on with the sleeves cut off, jeans on with a belt. And he was talking to somebody, hey homeboy, I said, who is it? You know, we was in a conservative little town. Your dad walking down the mall. Hey, homeboy. Hey, and all these white folks looking at him going, man, who's this guy?
Another time we had an all-girls trip and we all went to Canada. Joe remembers who I'm talking about. Canada.
And Carrie, our friend Carrie, who is always trying to get us to sing, always trying to make that money and try to, she's always get the hustle on. I swear she thinks she's our manager when we're all together.
I took advantage of the fact that JoAnna could sing. And I had her and the other, and Tracy Harris stand on the corner and sing so we can make money. And they did it.
And so we were up there. Kara's like, why don't you guys get on the corner and sing? And me and Joe were like, get on the corner and sing. You better pay us before we get on this corner and sing.
This, we were close. We were on Robeson Street in Canada. And we were close to a bar or something like that. And the bartender comes out and hears them singing and says, can you please come to the bar and sing for us?
We walked into some bar, holy spiritual women of God. No. And we were in this, I think it was like a pub or something. So Joe and I start singing, and then Carrie had people giving us money.
And people were like, you know, drunk. And the bartender's like, just sing anything. And Tracy and JoAnna start singing As a Deer Panthers After the Water, For the Water, So My Soul, in a bar with drunk people. And they were just like, yeah, woo, you know, just drinks for everybody. And I'm like, are you serious? But we left with some good money. We sure did. Mm-hmm.
And needless to say, Carrie could talk us into anything because we did it. But we had a nice dinner because we got paid.
We went to church, and I used to didn't like kind of riding to church with him because he played his music too loud. You know what I mean? So we get into church, and this guy gets up there, and he says, the pastor's up there on the stage. We're up in the balcony, and the pastor, a guy gets up. He's a missionary, and the pastor's talking about the missionary, and then the missionary said, Pastor, I will follow you anywhere. I'm sitting next to your dad. He gets up in the balcony of the church and yells, no, homeboy, no, homeboy, you don't follow no man. You follow Jesus. No.
There was a young man that liked her. I won't mention no names because she'll know who it is in that time frame. And so she came home, I won't say late, but you know, Uncle Johnny got on her that night and had a nice little time. You don't need to be out with no these young men and you single young lady, you need to have a chaperone and whatever it was. But she'll remember that, I know. And because the guys liked her. She was sweet, she had a lot of things going for her. So she was a little honeybee that they'd like to buzz, then you like to buzz around her. Let me take that back. She was a little flower. That's what I meant. She's a little flower that the bees like. No, she wasn't.
She was a sweet.
I'm telling corn on you because I don't think you're going to. I just kidding.
No, she wasn't no busy bee, you know, that kind of busy bee. She was a flower.
I'm about 11 at the time when he came in the picture. And somehow he wanted me to come to Tacoma for the weekend to hang out with him. And I was okay with that. My parents did put me on a Greyhound bus and send me to Tacoma at 11, where Cornelius picked me up. And I mean, obviously I was super comfortable and okay with traveling lonesome to go to Tacoma on my own. And so I remember just spending that weekend with him, and you know, he took me to a friend's house where she cooked dinner. I did a gymnastics show in the living room. I farted during the gymnastics show in the cartwheel, and I felt really embarrassed, but Cornelius was there to crack a joke and to, you know, make me feel okay. And that's what I've always loved about him. I've always been really comfortable with him. And, you know, and we stayed at his mom's house and I got breakfast cooked in the morning. And I mean, I guess that weekend really solidified it for me that, yeah, you can marry my sister.
I think he had met his match in JoAnna. I think there were just some things that she wasn't going to put up with. And he was used to doing his own thing. And I think once he got with Joe, I think he realized, man, I got to clean up my act. I can't, you know, be doing, you know, all these crazy things. I got, you know, I really like this girl. And I can't remember the details, but at one point, I think, and Cor might say something different, but I think Joe got was tired of him and she broke up with him. Or he broke up with, no, I think he broke up with her and she was like, forget you. And then she dyed her hair and she changed and she was looking all cute and stuff. And I think that he realized, hey, I don't want anybody else to have you. I want you for myself. And I can't remember the details because it's been so long, but I bet you Carrie could, or Joe could probably bring the details up. But I think it was, he broke up with her. And she was like, okay, so, okay then, I'm cool. Mm. And she went on and did her thing and he wasn't happy. It messed him up. And so he repented of his sins and came back to her.
We're going to Sweden. Everybody has their travel bags, right?
Mm-hmm.
And your dad's walking like this with a picture of your mother through the airport. And he was, so they start calling him Rook Williams. They go, you know, all the older players eventually say, what's up with your boy? So they start calling him Rook Williams. We went into, I think it was Sweden. So him and I roomed together on tour. Every time we go in the room, he'd find a fireplace and put your mom's picture up. And I was sitting there kind of going, man, what is up with this dude, man? You know? So he wasn't until your mom, when he met your mom, it was all over. He didn't even take a look back after that.
Did they ever break up? I'm sure they did, because most marriages, most datings, they have a breakup and then they get back and then they get married. At least that's what happened to me. I can only assume it happened. But yeah, they were a good couple together.
Again, I was young, but I remember JoAnna getting a whole lot happier when she met Cornelius. Like, I've seen some of the other boyfriends, you know, they were fine. But when Corn came in the picture, shoot, she was giddy and just more smiley and more joyous. And you could tell that this was a lot more deeper and a more intimate relationship than she's had in the past. So... I mean, I just remember her being smiling all the time once he came in the picture.
Remembering so well the day that I met you. You took me in your arms.
I remember it was raining and it started storming so bad, and Charlene, your grandmother, was worried that nobody, you'd have said, well, gosh, you know, this big storm just came up.
Oh, wow.
Out of nowhere. I don't know if anybody remembered that. But when we went upstairs, it was packed with people.
It sure was.
Because they showed up for your parents.
Yeah.
Because they love them.
Yeah.
You know, and so I do remember that. You remember that?
No.
Oh.
For one, because it was like, someone's getting married in our out of the siblings. It's like, oh my goodness, it's true. And it happened to be the oldest sibling, JoAnna. I was so happy on that day. And JoAnna was, your mom was the most beautiful bride. And why am I crying? Why am I getting teared up right now? But no. She was so gorgeous. I think her veil reminded me of a queen, like, you know, Queen Elizabeth. But she, I mean, everything about her was glowing.
all close friends and family getting together, and how it was just a blessed union. I just know that everybody was so excited and so supportive of these two, because we knew that this was going to be a forever thing. You know, two good people coming together, you know, and, you know, Joe had dated in their past and never, you know, it didn't amount to anything. Corn as well. But then when they got together, it was like, yes, this is what it's supposed to be. So it was just a wonderful celebration of people that we all love.
So all of us ball players, we all live together. So I have the house. So Off, Steve, and your dad lived with me at one point, because I was always going out on tour and I had the house. So I think Zach got married, Off met Carrie at his wedding. Steve got married and your dad met your mom at Steve's wedding. Then your dad got married and I met your aunt at their wedding. So all of us that kind of lived in the house, we all met our wives at each other's weddings.
I think I love that, how real they are. They call a spade, you know? They always continue to love each other in spite of when things are going bad, when things are going good, you know? They've just been a really great example of a picture of marriage. And even though it's not perfect, you know, they show just a couple that keeps God first, a couple that puts their family underneath that, and then their love for children, for both of them, you know, working with, you know, young kids, old kids. I mean, so many things. I mean, I tend to call JoAnna most in terms of, you know, stuff with my marriage. I didn't want to start crying, but I mean, you know, not having a mom, it's really easy to call JoAnna and to just ask anything about what I could be going through, or how did you handle this situation? And there's always some example of what example or advice that she can give to me. Because, you know, she's been through something, or, you know, just it, she's that person, and Cornelius is that person that I can go to in terms of marriage advice.
I think she would tell her how proud she is of her.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Oh, most definitely.
And that all these years, I'm just going to say she's been married to the same man, you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
And that I believe that she's in love, because you could be married and not in love.
Right.
And I think I've seen her always respect him.
Yeah.
And vice versa.
Mm-hmm.
I don't think I've ever seen her mad at him. That must be behind closed doors.
Probably.
That's the dog here.
But anyway, she's just a sweet, down-to-earth young lady. And we love her.
Most definitely.
Loved her.
Yeah.
Well loved here.
What I admire most about them is not what they did as a marriage, because anybody could stay together. There's a lot of marriage stay together, but they don't. But these guys have impacted the folks around them. You know, if there's no Corn and Joe, I'm not here. That's a guarantee. I was already traveling around the world doing my thing, and, you know, and if there's no them, if I didn't respect who, first of all, we didn't find girls like the Brown sisters. They were hard to find, you know? But at the time, I wasn't looking for a Brown sister. I was looking for another sister. But then after being around JoAnna and Corn and seeing how they are and then getting to meet your family, I said, man, I can't lose over here. You know, if I'm gonna take a shot, I'm gonna take the long shot here.
I'm so excited that you two chose to just continue this growth in your marriage as a representation of God's children, and that you two are totally a true testimony of what marriage looks like. It's such a sacrifice, but people have a lot of words to say. People have a lot of fluff words when it comes to either trying to be married or trying to, but words are cheap, as they say. You have to have the action. People can be saying, oh yeah, I love you, I love you, I love you. But one thing I know that I actually see, and I actually hear the love, and I hear it through, you know, JoAnna, when we're just maybe, you know, talking or whatever. I mean, I can tell that she's so in love with your dad. Still, I mean, just, it's like it hasn't diminished, but it's gotten stronger. I can see the growth in their love. And for me on the outside, to see how they on the inside how their love has grown, or when they go on dates still, when she'll say, oh, we're out here, they're looking like just like two peas in a pod. They look beautiful together. And I am so thankful that I have an exceptional, bar none, and meaning in comparison to, I can't even really think of like other couples right now, meaning of how much I love the example of what Corn and Joe have shown, what you two have shown the world and to me, of what real love looks like.
If it ain't broke, don't fix it. keep doing what you're doing. Build on what you're doing that's good, and learn from whatever mistakes have been made, whether it's communication or
communication,
or how you treat one another, or you know, just take it up a notch if you can, and keep the love alive. So I'll say, I keep it burning. Keep the love alive.
Yeah, and let each other know when something's wrong.
Yeah,
or if something's wrong.
Yeah,
and sit down and discuss it.
What you said, keep the love alive.
Yes,
both of you have been married longer than I have, but that is wisdom. Yeah. And but here's the thing. You're keeping your prayer life alive.
Amen.
Your relationship with the Lord.
Yes.
Because that keeps you.
Number one.
Keeps everything centered.
Yeah. Right. Keeps everything centered. Yes, as long as that's okay, and you can work on everything else.
Right.
But that always makes things
easier. Right. If that gets off kilter, everything else is going to get off kilter.
Exactly.
You guys are a testament to what love and commitment is. In these days, you don't see 30 years, you know, and it's a blessing to see the fruit from your union with your kids, and just what you're doing in the community, what you've been to so many people, you know, and I just am so proud to claim that because I got married, it brought you guys together. Look at how God just works it out. But I am so happy that you guys are still together. You guys are now empty nesters. You guys are still doing the things that God has called you guys to do. And I am so proud of what you guys have accomplished. And I wish you, and I pray for continued success in your marriage, continued laughter, continued sharing experiences together, and I pray that God continues just to bless your union for 30 plus more years. I love you guys with all my heart.
So I just want to say happy anniversary to Corn and JoAnna, and I don't know if the camera's going to pick this up, but I have, just a moment please, I have this picture that of them that we took. We were on a boat. Man, I wish I could look at Joe and her white and white and white and Corn. This is when it was part of the group of couples getting together, and we rode a boat. and we pick up a party boat. And so this is years ago. You guys are still married. I want to say happy anniversary and many, many more. And yeah, thanks for setting the precedent for your children and their children and their children. Happy
Felice.
Happy 30th anniversary. JoAnna
and JoAnna. Wait, we gotta do that over again.
Okay.
Do over.
Happy anniversary, Corn and JoAnna.
We love you. Love you. Keep going. 30 more.
Listen up, my love. Now if you thought I'd forget, I got some tricks up my sleeve. 2 tickets for us headed to paradise. Reservations done, check. Flowers in my hand smelling good, check. So tell all your friends to take a rain check. 2 tickets for us headed to paradise. Girl, it's my favorite day of the year. We gon' be making love all night, reminiscing on the good times. A day or later, it's on you. That's when you made the brand new. Today is a holiday for two. It's our anniversary. So every corner celebrates. She's to another year with me. Today is a holiday for two. It's our anniversary. It's our anniversary. Listen up, my love. Now look how far along we've come. You changed my life. No one could ever come close to the job that you've done. You're an angel on earth, one of the best of heaven.